For days, Israel has been bombarding Gaza, reducing entire areas to rubble. But the question is there an end game? Where does this stop, and when and how? Different sources have told Reuters journalists that they see no obvious sign of an exit strategy for Israel, that is, assuming they plan to exit. Nobody really knows at what point a military campaign will consider that its goals have been met and that we begin to hand over to a political situation. In the short term, the tactics are clear. They want to stop the rocket fire from Gaza and they want to crush Hamas. Gaza's just 360 square kilometers. Israel has mobilized 360,000 reservists to carry out this operation. So short-term goals like eradicating tunnels and maybe targeting individual Hamas leaders and killing them are no doubt achievable for a force that size. But beyond that, what happens? Hamas is not just a presence in Gaza. It has a presence across the occupied Palestinian territories. It has supporters across the Middle East and all around the world. So crushing Hamas is going to be very, very difficult for Israel, both militarily and politically. Other players in the region could also escalate matters. Iran, Hezbollah in Lebanon. If they get involved, Israel will have to fight on different fronts. The last comparable ground attack that Israeli forces took part in was in 2006 in Lebanon, when they crossed the border and went into South Lebanon to try and catch Hezbollah forces who had captured Israeli soldiers. Now, I was there, I saw that battle. Israel had not come up against fighters like Hezbollah's in the West Bank in previous decades. The question is, how ready is Hamas for them with its tunnels, with its booby traps, with its trained fighters? How ready are they? How many casualties would they inflict on Israel? How many casualties would Israel inflict on Palestinians? And what is the tolerance on both sides for this? All of this is unknown.